Today on Rockfeed, we're asking, what the hell happened to Crazy Town? Their smash breakout single Butterfly and those kick-ass frosted tips alongside the nautical star tattoos were pretty much enough for any band to take over the globe. But all jokes aside, Crazy Town did connect with millions of people fresh out of the gate. They were constantly on the radio with their single Butterfly, which, quick tip, that guitar loop in the song is actually a sample from a Red Hot Chili Peppers song called Pretty Little Dirty, as Roby 12345 aptly noted in the comments of this video. Crazy Town was peak nu metal, and they actually featured for a time the late DJ AM, who passed away due to a battle with substance abuse. And unfortunately, substance abuse was a recurring theme with this band. Vocalist Shifty Shellshock, or Seth Benzer, appeared on the VH1 show Celebrity Rehab featuring Dr. Drew, and it was at times difficult to see him in that state. Crazy Town burned bright, but they also burned fast. Their debut album, The Gift of Game, came out in 1999, and to date has sold over a whopping 1.5 million copies. From there, as they tend to do, the major labels latched on and the band released their follow-up record, Dark Horse, which was somewhat of a commercial disappointment. Crazy Town was a wild bunch from the beginning. In the year 2000, the group was booked to perform on Ozfest, though they were kicked off of the tour only 2 weeks in because their frontman Shifty Shellshock was reportedly arrested after he threw a chair through a window while intoxicated. Producer and co-vocalist Brett Mazur told MTV, "When it went number one in 15 countries, we were in Germany and pretty much everywhere else in the world, we were known for more than that song. But in the US was Butterfly, except for the kids who knew us from the second stage at Ozfest." MTV added, "While they had worked hard to earn their success, several of the group's members had debilitating drug habits, and the pressure to follow up Butterfly marked the beginning of the end." Speaking on the difficulty of following up their debut album, Brett Mazur said, "We were more than Butterfly, and when the second record came out and it wasn't a hip-hop crossover like that song, the label didn't know what to do with it." Interestingly enough, Mazur at least partially attributed the lackluster performance of their second album to the band's management at the time, who according to him, may have been preoccupied with the major artist that their management had just signed, none other than country music titan Shania Twain. He told MTV, "Everyone seemed to love the album, and then our management signed Shania Twain. We came back from Europe, and it was almost like the record was dead before it started." Unfortunately, this is mostly where the story ends as it pertains specifically to Crazy Town, though it wouldn't be the last that we would hear about their troubles. Frontman Seth Shifty Benzer spiraled out of control. Benzer self admits he battled addiction for a number of years and appeared on 2 seasons of Celebrity Rehab and 2 seasons of Sober House on VH1. Later, on March 29th, 2012, Benzer was reportedly hospitalized after losing consciousness, and he was in a coma and was later released from the hospital. Through a representative, Benzer later apologized through TMZ, saying, "Seth has completely changed his life around and has checked into a highly regarded drug and alcohol treatment center where he will be working with them to restructure his life over the next 2 years. Benzer said, "I would like to sincerely apologize to the parties involved. I feel very bad for those who I have offended and those who have endured this situation." Beyond that, it's believed that Benzer has maintained his sobriety. Since 2007, Crazy Town has reunited and released new music, but sadly haven't connected in the way they did with their debut album. Co-vocalist Brett Mazur has since departed the band, or at least he announced he won't be touring with the group anymore, but he left on good terms and intends to keep working with the band behind the scenes. After that, the rest of the band followed shortly thereafter, leaving only Seth Benzer as the original member of the band. Members Rick Dixon, Nick DiOrio, and Kevin Capler also left the band.
Okay, well, this is the new and improved Crazy Town. This is Stags. This is Hazma. And this is E.T.
For some reason, Shifty added an X to the Crazy Town name later on. It's unclear if this was some way to continue using the band name or if he merely just wanted to add an X to the name. For now, Crazy Town clearly intends to carry on with just Seth Benzer and a new host of bandmates. And there are likely still some people out there who want to see that. But it's hard not to wonder what might have been had Crazy Town been able to capitalize on that monumental early success that they had with their debut album, The Gift of Game. That's all for now. Thanks so much for joining us here at Rockfeed. And if you're new here, Be sure to subscribe with notifications on so you don't miss out on breaking hard rock and heavy metal news. You can also check out these recommended videos. Thanks so much for joining us, and we'll see you all very soon.